Hello and welcome to this edition of Game Time with Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn for PlayStation 3. Joining us as always is Chrono Oscillata, currently level 31 summoner. Yes, we were able to hit that summoner last episode and it's pretty cool. So, anyway, what we're going to be doing today is, last time when we were looking around for the summoner, we ran over to this little area where they're doing this, this Heaven's Turn event, whatever. So we talked to Demarius here. We just kind of shot through it. So let's see if she's going to tell us anything more again with that. So the Seed Seers conjecture that Nefika, the matron, will be the new goddess ascendant. Would that it signifies a time of peace and prosperity? Okay, so that really doesn't tell us too much on what we're up to. So anyway, we're going to try to go and have another chat to Uma Bingo right here. And of course, in case you guys can't tell, we are in the Minketo's amphitheater area. So anyway, let's go and check this out, see what they have to say. It's weird, has a little horse head on. In honor and glory do we first lay eyes upon one another. I am that which the betters and worse alike call Uma Bingo. Come from the far east to tend to the fire of friendship with your or Eorzea. Okay. Weirdo. A little weird. Yeah, I know, right? That's the perfect look. I see that your eyes wander in wonder to this artful helm. Well and good it is you're penchant in such matters. My lord, the selfsame kabuto you shall have. It's not a kabuto. Oh, it is a kabuto. I see. It's just a horse kabuto. Interesting. See you the lines of this kabuto? Oh, Lord. Strange it seems to your Eorzean eyes, but no Easterner would fail to recognize it as the horse, the totem of this coming turn. Yeah, that's exactly what I thought, the horse. Proper and customary it is for us to of the Far East to choose a totem before every heaven's turn. Now hear me, my lord, and hear me well, lest wonder quickly curdle to derision. I don't know what they're talking about exactly, as is wont to do with the Eorzeans. The way they talk, I promise you guys, this is not easy to read. Hoof Tanai, Eorzea knows not the horse for one reason and one reason only, the horse bird. I speak of that which the slow and the quick tongue alike call chocobo in your parlance. Yes, okay, yeah, there we go. Speak some sense that we know. The lay of your lands, the cut of your climbs, the plumpness of your posterior, the horse bird was admirably suited to Eorzea in every way, but was and is are no more alike than man bedded and man wedded, as we say in the Far East. You can keep that saying there. The scent of knowledge is on you, adventuring one, and so it needs but a mention that much has changed in Eorzea. The East would bring the horse to water if Eorzea is ready to drink, if my lord takes my mixed meaning. Truly and secretly, 'twas my mission to begin the horsing of your fair lands when the new totem proved a horse. It seemed the 12 smiled upon us, for even in Eorzea, minds arc high and wide during Heaven's Turn. Yet I am stymied, for the laws of your woods say no horse may enter the Black Shroud if my faithful steed is not to present his noble self. How will the Eorzeans know the beauty of the horse? Assuredly and absurdly, you must be the answer to my prayers. Else, my lord, I must return to the Far East empty-handed. No horse may enter the Black Shroud, but an adventurer may. Clear and clandestine is our way. You, my lord, must don the kabuto and be the horse. I'm going to embrace my inner horse just so I don't have to hear you talk again. In humility and jocundity, I receive your assent. Don the kabuto, then, my lord, and aid your Yoriki, 3 in Gridania, Limsa Mensa, and Olda. No mere mummery. This that you do, my lord. You must embrace thee and Quinn if the noble horse is to ever canter along the strange and off-putting horse bird throughout the breadth of Eorzea. What the freak? Okay, so apparently you want me to wear this in Limsa, Gridania, and Ulda. So I'm just gonna complete it. Okay. And see if she has a different thing for us. There we go. Okay. So now we have a couple of different ones. Let's see what you have to say first. Alright, turn around, beautiful. Okay. You're gonna give me another one of these. Interesting, okay. See what you have to say. An adventurer of this unkind land who would embrace the horse and assist us. The Umba Bugio is a lady most subtle to find such a one. How are things, you ask? Quite bad, thank you. Cold shoulders and colder cabbage soup are rewards for tireless attempts to show the beauty of the horse to these ingrates. Are they beautiful? What a question. But no matter, I shall have to fill that gaping void in your sensibility that your begetter so unthinkingly let you with. Yes, the horse is more beautiful than your chocobos, and it falls upon you to prove the point. Can we get this show on the road? Do you mean that you are eager to begin the mission? Very good. Don your kabuto and take yourself to Bent Branch Meadows, where the one who serves me with the heart of a son and strength of a brother will guard you. Okay, so head to Bent Branch Meadows when I put on the kabuto. Perfect. So first things first, I believe we need to put on this kabuto. Little horse thingamajig. We're going to run around with this shirtless. Because, I mean, honestly, how else can you do this? No, we'll put on some clothes. We'll just change that. We'll have some fun with it. Let's see. Here we go. Put on a reindeer gear. Reindeer gear and a horse suit. That should be fun. First of all, let's get a look at us, huh? Definitely weird. Okay. All right. See what you're talking about here. You're going to give me something, a Zoni, for a meal for gathering. Yours is to advocate for the noble horse in Gridania, Limsa Limsa, and Ulda. They that look to me for wrath and succor already toil in these cities three. And if your efforts bear fruit, a kabuto of colors varied you shall have. Gather all three, golden, black, and crimson, and present yourself before me in a manner customary for such occasions. So now, my lord, know that in the east, the journey belongs to the man, but the destination to his master. This pageant of kabuto must follow an order proper, but the quests are yours to order as you like. We must begin with gold, for it opens that chamber of the heart where sings the canary of convotice. Do not be baffled, my lord. We of the east must take place for our desires. Okay, whatever. What was that all about? I have no idea what she was talking about. While we're in the golden Umba Kabuto, speak with somebody. Okay. Okay, so what we're going to do is, first off, take off to Bent Branch Meadows like how the guy who we could understand told us to do. So, with this being said, Bent Branch Meadows, 150. Yeah, this is definitely a little weird. Really makes me not want to go to the Far East at all. If that's how they talk. I'm just going to be doing like most people do and just keep clicking through the chats. It's just gonna be wasted time that somebody did. Okay, Bent Branch Meadow, wearing my gear. Where is this man at? Zoom it in. A little further up. Right under us, there we go. You there, idiot. Ifrideggy, come on, I need you out the way. There you go. Okay. Alright, you. A little weird. Okay. Judging for the Kabuto, I take it you are on our side. Welcome to Bent Branch Meadows. Foolish name, considering most branches are bent. But then again, I am among fools here. Yes, you are. Yes, fools. They have eyes, but will not meet my gaze. They have ears, but will not listen to my petition. The only things they do use in a manner proper are the likes, with which they scurry away like milk-livered children. To one of their own kind, though, they must turn their gaze and unstopper their ears. So please, good sir, strike a pose and show these galoots the beauty of the horse. I have learned that the way of an Orzian single-chambered heart is through the chocobo. If you can show the horse in a light favorable to those overgrown fowls, then perhaps you will succeed where I have not. But for that, you must sally to where the horse birds gather and pose amongst them. Let the chocobo keeps witness the pose off, and then the truth blast the amber from their eyes and the wax from their ears. So go to the chocobo stables and pose. Okay, very interesting indeed. So we're going to come over here. I guess this is our destination. Right here, and we're just going to simply pose. Bump emotes. We're going to throw pose onto our hotbar. As soon as we find it. Strike a pose. There we go. And since we're right here, we'll throw it right there. Okay, perfect. So we'll just do this. Look at it. Working it. Quick. Okay, done there. Where else would you like me to pose at? Right over here. I'll talk to the Chocobo Keep. There we go. Now, what are you up to? You're scaring them, is what? Knock it off. Do you think the horse is a beautiful creature? Don't rightly know what you mean by that, but sure, I guess the real thing would look fair enough. A sight better than that thing on your head, that's for sure. Are you going to stop horsing around now? It's heaven's turn. And look at all the ruffled feathers. You take yourself off to a tavern like the gods fearing man. Okay. So I did what I had to do over here. Excellent. Strike the pose with the chocobos. They seem to enjoy it. Ah, comely, he called the horse. Out of the mouth of foes comes the greatest compliments. Bitter has been the battle of Bent Branch Meadows, and sweeter for it the victory. Afeard, you say, what craven birds are these to quail so before the overmastering beauty of the horse? But lest I forget, the horse is merciful and generous in victory, more generous than I would be, frankly. Go and rally these shrink-claws chocobos and show that in beauty of mind too, the horse is superior to the bird. So let me go back now and rally. Okay, I don't rally at all normally, so it's definitely going to be one of those things we add. Rally ho! Okay. Hey, you can see where. I don't know if you guys ever watched it, but you can always check my favorites, and you can see the emotes of each of the different classes or clans. There you go, different clans. Chocobos respond with much excitement. Okay, fantastic. Did I just say something to you? No, good. Yeah, so I did a emote video. Those are my first videos that I was doing when I was practicing using all my stuff. So yeah, yes, adventurer. These are tears you see upon my cheek, seeing you rally those horse birds so. What a curious land you hail from. You are more discomfited by a man's tears than by a man's blood. Yet your masterful rally evokes my beloved steed, with all eloquence of the east. Is that thunder? Does that mean Ifrit or Odin's around, I wonder? Is that just rain? Huh. As unschooled as you are, we have captured the beauty of the horse. The tears you regard unease are a testament to your empathy. Most okay, whatever. Okay, nothing more remains to be done at Bent Branch, so overmastering has been your achievement. Take this carrot and golden whatever as proof of your success. May the gods speed your way to Gridania. Okay, done with that there. With the Amobagaya. Deliver that's okay to Gridania. Yeah, it seems to have gotten dark. I am going to check this out just in case, guys. Just in case, see, Quarry Mill, 153. Yeah, we're going to shoot over to Quarry Mill just to see if Odin is out, because I remember that it said that the skies would get dark whenever he was summoned. So if that's the case, I'll figure why not pop in, right? Gord before hide and seek does not look like we have it. The dark divinity right here is another part of our quest that we'll be doing a different time. I don't even know what level it is, 46 for that, so yeah, we're not really too worried about that, but yeah, I want to see if there was an Odin fate anywhere about here. Got the doo-doo mistress. Yeah, no, it doesn't seem like they have it going on, so with that being the case, we will use our return spell, take back off to Gridania. Yeah, it never hurts to go ahead and check it out, you know. I figured just in case, because we have not actually seen Odin this time around. I've ran into Bahamut, and that was an absolute nightmare, because he would disappear. And then it reappeared like every once in a while, because there was just too much going on, and it wouldn't load him, because it was loading everybody else. So it made things very difficult to even see him. But when he did pop in, I saw him pop in once, and he was just attacking some people. So he was pretty awesome to see that. But then he just disappeared, and then next thing I know, I was dead. So apparently, I got hit with something, you know. Anyway, let's see here. Old Gridania is where we're heading to. Back over to Minketo's app. Oh, no, crap. Wrong one. So frustrating. See, that's what I always figured, though. Whenever you're in a rush, keep trying to go through things too fast, you end up putting yourself even further back. Because like there, I was trying to hurry up and hit Minketo's amphitheater. Accidentally clicked it one too many times, and it sent me back. So now, instead of being in Minketo's, we're right back here to try again. Same thing with traffic. You know, a lot of people, there wasn't a rush to make it someplace. If you end up getting in an accident or dying, then a lot of work that was. Now you're never going to make it on time. So yeah, need to just kind of calm down and enjoy it. I think I'm more frustrated that this event is so hard to follow. Just want it to be over with already. That is one suggestion I would like. I love it that they really do take the time to type out the text based on people's accents that they have. Like the, for instance, the pirates, that they always talk off god awful and whatnot. But still, like, I just feel like there should be like a setting where you, if you want that, cool, but if not, then how about you just don't even worry about it, and you can just talk regular for us. Just options, I suppose. Okay, would I like to hear your report? Yes, I believe we would both be served by it. Well, what say the Doshin? Were you able to instruct those chilly chocobo keeps in the beauty of the horse? Doshin's carrot. He gave you this, and wept in a manner most manly, most lacking in imagination is that one. and for him to see evocations of that which is more most precious to him in life. Your inner horse, my dear adventurer, must be a steed of rare beauty. Perhaps the West is not without its own subtlety. The golden Yuma Yoriki, thank you for the assistance. When the noble hoofbeats of the horse ring through these woods, know that you are ever remembered, and this Kabuto, too, shall remind you of that deed. What good is it? Your questions have grown less discomfiting as I warm towards you. what good is this Kabuto? You shall ever look upon it and remember this heaven's turn, and the inner horse of great beauty that canters through the chambers of your heart. You can do no more to persuade your strange countrymen of the beauty of this of the horse. May you have success as great in other lands, and may the Uma Bugyo find you not wanting. Okay, so that finished that up. Interesting. Now we're gonna throw on this golden horse piece. And now that allows us to talk to you, the golden horse piece. I see and mark the golden Yuma Kabuto. Let us agree that Gridania has been tutored in the beauty of the horse. That which is called beauty by the base and the fine alike is but a dream of song. And though everyone echoes a hoofbeat in Eorzea, now as well as the Far East. Now comes red, for we must remember, my lord, that where gold goes, blood flows. The crimson Uma Kabuto of Limsa awaits an advocate worthy. Okay, so off to Limsa then. I think. Let's make sure first. Just to be on the safe side first. I'll look around just to make sure there's nothing out here. Perfect. Okay, Limsa, because that's expensive. Look at that, 618 gil I have to pay. Just to make it there, so I want to make sure that that's exactly where we need to go at. This stuff, I'll probably be spending about 2,000 is what I estimate, 2,000 gil, just on travel. So I want to make sure I'm traveling to the right places. So far, I'm probably tallying up about like 800 to 900. And don't look at my money and think that, oh yeah, you're just being a stingy. Yes, I'm being stingy. That's how I got the money. Don't you think it just comes to everybody? So, in Limsa Limensa, most of their fairs and everything happen on Af Castle. So, we shoot to the Af Castle. We're going to see if that's where it's at. Just like for Gridania, it's always in Minketo's Amphitheater. And in Ulda, it is on the Ruby Red Exchange. So, I'm going to start off there. It's always a great place to start if you're looking for seasonal events to see what's going on with it. And honestly, I can't remember seeing it whenever you log in. It pops in the chat log. But I didn't pay any much attention to it because I had other things I wanted to do. But I'm glad that I accidentally flagged the quest because I would have probably missed it. And I would have been really sad to miss our very first seasonal event, you know. So I'm glad we didn't miss it. Okay, the red Yuma Yorkari, okay. My lord knows the role we play in this enterprise, I'm hoping. Rescuers, my lord, rescuers, fair Eorzea, fettered in feathers, shackled to shame. It is sad, no? So on horseback we are riding to the rescue. I am liking Eorzea, the sights, the food, the people, but not the horse birds, no. Wretched queuing things. If we of the east must be saving Eorzea from wretched mounts. I am talking of boyish things, my lord. With pardon, yes? Let us speak now of your task. The harvest. It proceeds at the Red Rooster Steed. They are needing a nice, strong horse, but do they know it? No, my lord. I am thinking perfect. What chance to show the strength of the horse? I am having a nice cob on the steed already. You are to help him carry the harvest. Go, go. Okay. I wonder if they're going to give me a bird for completing this. That'd be pretty cool. Or not a bird, a horse. Okay, so I'm not really 100% sure where the Red Rooster Steed is at. I believe it's this area, I believe, but I'm not 100% sure. We'll find out right here. Yes, that's it. Okay, so speaking of those birds, let's go ahead and pop on to ours. And this all comes down into it where, as nice as it is, chocobos are the main mode of transportation. Those and airships, and it's been that way in all the Final Fantasy series. So I really do enjoy my chocobo, and I'd rather not have a horse. But I mean, already I have the unicorn mount now, so why not? What can it hurt? Thought I saw somebody behind me. Yeah, what can it hurt? I'm just gonna go ahead and go ahead and pick up the mounts or whatever and participate in the events because, again, somebody over there at Square Enix spent a lot of time trying to think of this. And he got his team together and all this nonsense and had to type up, do the research of how people talk and graphic designs and all that good stuff. Yeah, so somebody had to do it. So I figured, why not just take a peek at it, and I'm not gonna let their work go to waste. Oh, it looked beat up. Ow, ow! If I call you, my lord, will you put that Kubota on? Which one? You want this one? There you go, that's what you want. Okay, so you gotta put on the brown one. Pat, pat. Come to relieve me. Oh, thank the 12. Blasted Yoriki and his ideas. He's Northeasterner, you know? They're all off their gourd. Ah, put my back out. No matter where to transport the harvest from the steed. Some proof of a horse's power. My back went before I actually collected the vegetables or loaded the wagon. The harvest still scattered hither and yon. Gather up the harvest and hand them to the farmer, won't you? Then you can hitch yourself to the wagon and show all the horsepower the Yoriki blathers on about. So apparently we are the horses. Because we got these little helmets on. Yes, that's not how things work out at all. So just because we got these helmets, we're supposed to be playing these horses that are able to do all this laborious work. No, that's exactly what horses do. They do all that work. Not me. I'm an adventurer. Which brings us back to my age-old little chat that I like to have every now and then. Is that being an adventurer in real life pretty much would not be the thing to do. I would end up. Yes, it's just like a lot of laborious work. So, pretty much, if you guys want to be an adventurer in real life, just go out and start doing favors for people. You can build up your reputation that way. Go mow people's lawns and help them carry their groceries or whatever until they give you something more challenging to do, and then you do it. So yeah, that's not for me. I'm a little too lazy for that. Okay, finish this up. Now we gotta give it to a farmer. Where's the farmer at? A little further this way. Okay. So that's a little sprint. There we go. Steed botanist. Good gods, another one of those horse mummers. We can't all be having fun and games during the harvest, you know? What's this? Hauled me some carrots, did you? Well, that's a useful sort of mummer now. Not like the last one. Man couldn't lift a twig. Got a strong back there, do you? Powerful sort of shoulders. A mummer could make himself even more useful and carry the giant carrot left there by the field. Great. Right, I see it. Enormous carrot. Fantastic. That's a pretty decent sized carrot. Doesn't look all that heavy though. Make our way back over here. Here again, I just noted that the whole reason that chocobos were around is because horses were not around. So that's interesting. Well, have the giant character, didn't you? I did. Oh ho, really put your back into this one, huh, fella? That ought to do her, at least for this harvest. Don't need you anymore. All I got to do is hitch this wagon to a chocobo and... What? You want to pull the wagon instead? That's my kind of crazy talk. I appreciate that, but no thanks. Believe you would pull the cart, though. Horses are that strong. Eh? Well, or at least you are. See if we can talk back to our injured guy over here. There he is. Okay, what you got for us? My lord, you're back. He said, "What? Horses are that strong?" Well, there's our task done. Nobody had to hitch themselves to a wagon. I can call that a win. You make a fine horse, my lord. A sight better than me. Why, if I really were a horse, I'd be for the knacker now. You've more than earned this carrot. Give it to the to that beast from the northeast and my message too. I'm thinking a red rooster steed is one amazing show of horsepower. Full stop and ow. Okay. So 170. Okay, so back to them Slavensa now. Oh my goodness. This is a very long seasonal event, guys, I mean, we already reached our normal time for the videos, but that's okay, because I still got some more to go. I still got to make it to Old Dyer, and that's just being assumptive that I've actually completed everything here in Limsa the Mensa. So we'll see. Time will tell. Get off of that first person real fast. Eighth and that. Da 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 da. Af Castle. But yes, very interesting. We ran through a couple different seasonal events so far within the first two seasons of Game Time, or first three seasons of Game Time, sorry. And that's because it released, about August. So of course the August release, summertime, blah blah. Then Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's. Next up should probably be the Valentine's one, and then yeah. Pretty much had something just about every month. It's pretty cool. All right, let's see what you got to say, sir. Good result you are having down at the Red Rooster Steed. Tell me, my lord. I'll just give you this carrot. Oh, the Doshin's carrot. He's back. He is thrown out. Some poultice I am sending then. The vegetables are reaching Limsa the Mensa, but do you know what else, my lord? The reputation. Horses, Limsans are hearing. Horses are strong. Now you are taking this crimson kabuto for all your pains. Doshin, my lord, is kind to be remembering him, but a poultice he is already getting. No idea what that is. The rescue of Eorzea is almost done. I'm thinking how pleasant it is to be having a Lamincin Lapri pie now. My lord gives the notion. My lord has more work to do, and only then is he visiting the Umbobugia in Gridania. Okay, so I got more work to do. Okay, no. Okay, got the red one here. Okay, what else do we have to do? Well, we're in the red one. Oh, speak, I gotta go back to. Okay, so now we got the red one on us, as you can see. Alright. Now we are to take off to back to Gridania using the return spell, because that saves us some money. And then Ethernet to Mikado's Amphitheater, talk to the guy, and then we're gonna head on all the way over to Olda, and that should hopefully get us going. So here we go, time to sock ourselves up, get a little energy going into the video, yeah, because we're about one third of the way done, hopefully is what we're hoping for. So here we go. Ethernet. Okay, Mikado's Amphitheater. Suck it up. That was a nice little hold. Did pretty good. Sorry, I just wanted to throw a little something to keep myself awake, because it's kind of late over here. So yes, kind of late, and this is actually, not gonna lie, it's pretty boring. It's a pretty boring seasonal event for stuff that I really don't care much for. I see, and mark the crimson Uma Kabuto. Let us assent that Limsa has learned of the power of the horse. Prodigal it is that Doshin fell in the line of duty. Were it not for Malor's assistance, these Limsons would see not the horse as a helpmeet. The pageant must end in black, betokening the darkling of the senses that the bold and craven alike called death. Malor knows I speak of the black Uma Kabuto of Olda. Okay. So, off to Olda then. Rawr, 462, there we go. So that should put our total up there to about 1300 now, right? 13, possibly 1400. Because I also used that 170 to get back from Red Rooster Steed to Limsa, so yeah. We can round that to 1500. Alright, so just also be throw a little fun into it. I'm going to predict that they're going to send us to... So they'd send us Red Rooster Steed. I think they're going to send us to Camp Blackbrush. That's what I think. We'll see. I need to go make it to... Oh, it's actually right out here. Which direction, though? We'll find out. That way, to our left. Da 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 da. Here we go. What you got for us? Mark you as an adventurer. Come to our aid. Hello. I am that which the East and the West alike call the Black Uma Yoriki, though low. One knows the name by heart and the other by ear alone. To Olda I was sent to tell the speed that the birthright of the horse. A horse have I shouted these tales of fleetness, no pun intended, but a man's voice is a poor substitute for a horse or a gallop alack. A man a run, however, such makes a better substitute, but only a man fleet of foot would do. Hard would I charge if I felt myself equal to the task, but lo, a lifetime on horseback makes a poor runner indeed. Now an adventurer in the prime of his life may achieve this spirit, if not this substance, of the speed that lo sends manes flying and hearts thundering. Such and that are yours to achieve. One who whiles her life away in the benevolent shadow has placed markers along the road to Silver Bazaar. As the winds of the east race to the storm coat, you must run, horse-like in your speed, from marker to marker, and so on to the Silver Bazaar, using naught but your own two legs. Okay. Got you. So the Silver Bazaar, I have no idea which one that one is. Let's go select, go down. Run to the marker, 88 cents. It's in West Adelaide. Hammerly. Is this Blackbrush area? No, it's not. It's not. Where is this, honestly? Is that Horizon? That's Horizon, okay. Alright, so steps and knolls exit, so we need to make it to. Western Thanaland, right there, okay. Wrong direction, haha. Okay, here we go. Down this way. Right around here. Okay, I was really hoping I was close. So we're close with that Black Brush guess. But it's okay, because Black Brush would be Central Thanaland. Just be a quick teleport though. This should be the area we need to go to. Yes, West Thanaland. And one of the new things that they did add is you could check it out there. Showed real fast before we zoned. But yeah, you can shoot to the map, scroll on over, and it shows what areas actually hold your quest or future quest that you need to hit up. So here we go. Use our sprint for now. You guys remember when we first started off, before we had the option to actually fly on or use mounts? What travesty is this? We could probably see not a horse on the Imakaboto is the most important journey. Who said that to me? Apparently you need the brown one. Okay, we're gonna step outside of this and we're going to try again. I see. Okay, so each of those are the markers. So the red one's what you have to hit through as we're galloping through. So with that being the case, we can see exactly where we're at. Yep. Wonder right through the middle maybe. Who knows? Make it out of it. Nice. Second marker's right in the middle of that fate. Yeah, so you just have to run right through it. Sprint again. Fate joined, but we are going to just make it right through here. I see, and these markers are also this too. Also the little leaves. Oh, apparently did it. Beg pardon a moment of your time. Now, here's a curious sight. A fellow in a most particular helm running up this road like fire through tinder. It's upset the chocobo something fierce. Embracing your inner horse, you say, advocating for an eastern mount? Nonsense. You see a fella running his heart out in an outlandish helm, and you think there must be a good reason for a fella to mortify himself so, and you wonder just how swift this horse must be for him to go to all this trouble and nonsense. Thank you. The revolution comes. New mounts to rival chocobos, even replace them. What does it mean? Whom shall I tell? And how might I make a few gil off of this? I thank you kindly for the information, horseman. Spread the word of the horse's speed far and wide. We who adopt the mount early will have a greater joy of it. Okay. Okay, we're still running. Yep, we're still running. Okay, so still just right along the path. You can see in the distance, so we really don't have to keep up our map for too long, hopefully. Look it through. Cleared that one too. There we go. Should be eight markers, I believe they said, right? I think they said eight, if not five, five or eight. We'll set 5 then. Because from this point, then it takes us right back here. Then traveling the Stony Road. Alright, through the Silver Bazaar. We're gonna have a chat too. This lady, I suppose? Right here? You've finished your task, my lord. Well, did you run your appointed course? I have watched you from afar and near, like an eye you were as a charger, who could fail to be awed by the spittle flying from beneath your kabuto. Your boots as thundering hooves sending up plumes of dust, your taut flanks gleaming with sweat. Well, a worthy mount you would make, my lord. Yeah, that's what she said. Ha 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 ha, did it dooch. I am not the only horse lover in the Silver Bazaar tonight, I'll wager. I saw many a pair of eyes shining at the sight of flying manes, lips parted as though to drink in the muscular gallop. This girl's tripping completely off her rocker. And did you yourself not feel a dim echo of the exhilaration that is the natural gift of riders and mount alike? So long have we of the East partaken of this, that we feel the need for speed. It is our custom to reward a horse with a carrot. Take this, my fleet, piebald steed, and present it to the Black Uma Eurekian Ulda. Okay, so she said to the black one, so where's Ulda, man? 92 gills, so the black one. Older, not the one in Gridania. If you guys were to accidentally teleport to Gridania, that would suck. Okay, here we go. Pushing on. Almost 50 minutes. I was thinking if we do an hour-long video, that's normally a dungeon time video. 30 minutes is your typical game time episode. And anything longer than that ends up being one of our specials. So this might actually end up counting as a special. We'll see. See how long it takes us to finish it. But a dust upon your coat, and lo, the foam upon your chest. I mark the celerity of your journey hither. What have you there? A carrot that I was supposed to give you. A carrot? However did you ruse the docent to such favor, such fervor? A seeker of pleasure and a spirit most free she is. But since arriving in Eorzea, she has been as watered wine, alack. Much do we value speed in the East, for lo, life is hard and full of besiegement. We can part in uncertainty, safety, or gallop in certain rapture. An adventurer carries himself in much the same way. Ha! No wonder it is that you succeed beyond my wildest hope. This is your reward, lo, a kabuto that is a twin to my own. Never plod, adventurer. Death shall unhorse us, everyone. But until then, lo, we shall center, we shall gallop, we shall leap. The word shall spread through the Ulda of the speed of the horse. You have hot-footed and high-tailed your way to glory and grace. Continue your work for the Uma Bugyo, I say, then return to her in Gridania. Okay, well, we're in the black one, and you go back to the email bucket, so. It's not ready yet. It sounds like 15 minutes. Well, crap. Yeah, like I said, can't really wait for that, because the video is already pushing towards the time. Gridania. What do we call? New Gridania is where we need to be at. Ugh. Yeah, that little small sliver, if you look at it, small little sliver up there in the white, that'll probably take another 30 seconds. So, yeah, just to go ahead, run through this, because that 30 seconds could be well used in the blackness of these zoning points. So we have to hit 2 of them. All Right, there we go. And just in case you guys are wondering, not really sure if you were or not, but who cares? If you were wondering, I am doing most of these quests under my Arcanist slash Summoner because the other ones are kind of leveled up and I wanted to save those for the storyline. So, yeah, because once I hit 50, I won't get any more experience points applied to whatever character that's at 50. So, okay, here we go. See and mark the Black Kabuto. Let us accept the schooling of Olda as a deed of speed, done and dealt. The speed of the horse is a grace unmatched. That which is named Olda, my lord, is but a millstone that grinds in the desert. Sorely in need it is of such grace. Gold, crimson, black, noted and marked, and so the pageant is complete. Let us to another matter attend. Tongues waggle and curiosity peaks about the horse. Such is my lord's success. Yet others would deny their fellow Eorzeans even in the mildest flirtation with the horse. My lord, and here is that we must strike. Ugh. Those they call the fraternal order of Choco Whackers, in the harsh accents of Eorzea, are the fronds that fan the flames. In their iron grip toil the chocobos of burden here in Gridania, and no rivals will they brook. Yet do they not say the northeast, the people are speaking, the gods are speaking. Even the chocowhackers dare not resist the groundswell of support. My lord knows that our eastern countenance freezes the tongue and hurries the feet. Don the Umo Kubota again, and for you falls the task. The people shall speak their minds straight to the horse's mouth. Okay, so put back on this one here. And do what now? Run around, talk to people, okay. Meline. Hello there. Is that the horse Kabuto that's the talk of the town? It puts me in mind of a rare beast I saw in the hinterlands of Quirthus. A unicorn, they called it. I saw it just that once, but you don't forget something that beautiful. Horses are beautiful too, aren't they? What a fair sight it'd be to have them here. Okay, there's supposed to be somebody else. Who would be the other one? In New Gridania. Perfect, so which one's this one? I hope that's the exit. We'll try for it. Yeah, I hope that's the right one we need to head to. We'll try and see. Very worst case scenario is it's not the right entrance to the New Gridania area we need to go to, and we just have to run a little further. As long as he didn't send me to like these other three cities again, that would suck. I would really hate that, to have to talk to two people in each city. Ugh. That would be garbage. A lot of unnecessary traveling in my eyes. You, sir. Or ma'am. Whatever you are. That's a horse, right? I know all about that. It's faster. Faster than anything. An adventurer from Old Duh says he saw one. He just caught a quick look before it disappeared. That's how fast. I want one so bad. Interesting. So they fell for it. All right, now let's see here. Hold on, let's see, I might be missing something here. Let's see here. Oh, we're in the Umo Kabuto. Speak of horses in Old Gridania. What up to? My Enola Gridiron? No. Interesting. Interesting indeed. Okay, so I ran to New Gridiron, talked to somebody. Talked to somebody in Old Gridiron already, too. Now, wants me to talk back to somebody again in Old Gridiron. All the way up there. By the Lancer's Guild. So for that, we shall hit this Aetherite Shard. Take us to the Lancer's Guild. Then from the Lancer's Guild, we should be right next to that person. Hopefully talk to them. And transfer it back using the Aethernet shard to Minketo's Amphitheater. So that's the plan. We'll see how well we can stick to it. You there? Well, I'd be lying if I said your helm, Kabuto, it is called. If I said your Kabuto was not without some appeal, it grows on you. Especially since I hear the actual beast is a powerful creature and needs some studying, of course, but any tactical advantage against the Guardians would be welcome indeed. Alright, so that does it for that too. And now we should be heading back over to New Gridania again, is that what it says? Is that seriously what it says? Yes, back to the Chocobo Steep. Alright, so apparently that's exactly where we're going to be heading to. Where is it at? There we go. Ethernet Plaza will be perfect for us, so we'll go hit that real quick. Okay, and there we go. Chocobo Keep somewhere around this way. It's really weird trying to run on things with... Oh, should be this direction. There we go. Chief Chocowacker. Oh, for the love of the 12, the entire day spent dealing with inquiries about this horse thing. We deal in chocobos, people. And what can I help you with? Oh, you're one of those horse folk. Come to harass us in person, You brought the voice of the people. What is that? Some sort of periodical? Oh, want one so bad? Tactical advantage? Well, fair sight. These are just personal opinions. You're not changing our minds with this dross. Eorzea has a long and proud tradition of portage. We are a chocobo-based economy, you know. This newfangled horse thing has no place here. Say no to alternative portage. If that Ume Bugio insists on waving those horse head on our turf, will bring out the big birds. You can be sure of that. Since you helped them, you're helping us now. I've sent for the finest chocobo Corithus can breed. Bring that Bugio to Tree Speak Stables, and we'll put her in her place. Where's Tree Speak Stables at? I'm not really sure. Not really 100% sure about that location. Okay, back. A lot of traveling this episode, guys. Lots of traveling here. Aethernet. Minketo's again. Lots of traveling. So this is very good because if you think about it, if we did not have the Aethernet shards, you can imagine how long this episode would have been if I had to do all of it. We probably had to break it up into like 4 or 5 different parts just for the traveling part of it alone. So very, very glad that they threw the Aethernet shards in there, but because of that, they're making us really use them, too. Okay. Oopsies. No, I don't want to talk to you. Talk to you. Melora relayed the voice of the people to those high-necked chuckle-whackers. They were suitably humbled, I assume, yet ask. And I am schooled that an answer assumed is unlike an asking answered. What? Irrational and partial these chuckle-whackers are, and they shame even the horse bird in their witlessness. A chuckle-based economy, indeed. A long and proud tradition of non-competition is what is meant by the left and the right side of her mouth alike. Far have I come to stroke the flames of accord with Eorzea, Lord, and these chuckle-whackers would see it turn to cold ash. Nay, Nay, I say. This challenge I will accept, my lord. Will guide me to this tree speak stables, and there I will face off against the keeper of the horse beds. I don't know where that's at. Where's Chief North Shroud? Got you right with Yellow Serpent's Gate. Yes, that we can do, okay. Alright, so with this being the case, right here. Definitely did travel all around Eorzea for this, though. Yellow Serpent. Okay, here we go. So, Yellow Serpent Gate. And personally, I really prefer Chocobo's game, like I said, but I don't like how that Chocobo lady kind of made it seem like she spoke for the whole realm, you know, whatever. So, just because of her, I kind of would like to see a little different competition. Just because of what she said. But before that, I was still on Chocobo's side. Oh, showdown of the century. In honor and glory do we first lay eyes on each other. You are that which is called the chief of Choco workers by Eorzeans and Outlanders alike. I am the Embo Bugio. Thank you for coming, esteemed visitor from the far east. Let's settle this thing once and for all, shall we? A truly magnificent chocobo is about to arrive in these stables. After that, we can both go home because it will be pretty clear, even to you, that we've no need of horses in Eorzea. Your initial courtesy was as a thin soup before a meal of bones. You speak of things becoming clear, my lady, but there is no clarity in your own mind, only folly. Thanks to this adventurer, most beautiful, fleet, and powerful, Eorzea desires to know more of the horse. Is that not clear to you? Excuse me? You think a cheap stunt like that means anything? The last guy to put on a funny hat and clown about was selling lardy cakes, and people talked about that for a few days, too. Funny hat. A work of high art and cunning craft this is. And in the image of mine own Corsair Fair, I don't know. Scurrilousness? The scurry what? Nobody in yours even understands what you're saying. That's true, I can second that. As for your precious horses, they're just unicorns with a big empty forehead. Hornless. Abandon your quarrel. Your tongues are sharp enough to shave an urchin. Tree speaks sense for the finest chocobo in Corthus, and I have brought it. Thus, now, what ails you that you would keep me waiting? Oh, yes, a horse hat on, too. Dum da dum. But that armor is Hurric. No, that can't be. Excuse me, who are you? Did I send for a horse head to deliver my chocobo? Well, if you cannot name me, I have no name to claim. The helm I bought off a passing adventurer. It has a certain vigor that appealed to me. Esteemed visitor from the east, I have the honor to have been born under the unicorn sigil of a proud horse. Horn or no, I know the love you bear for the mount of your homeland. The supple muscles under the silky coat, the music of the hooves, the velvet of the muzzle, and the inscrutable black sea of their eyes. Ah, the horse. But I am also a man of Quirthus, where the love of chocobos runs as deep as their bloodline runs pure. Which is better, bird or horse? I could not say. You could not say. Exactly useless then. What was that so soliloquy? My lord seems not to comprehend that I am now honor bound to prove the horse superior to this chit. Then your honor is forfeit as is hers. The finest creature here is neither the horse nor the chocobo. but my trusted comrade of many adventures, Krona. Look at the scars upon his Kabuto. How mighty he must have toiled to become a horse and against all odds succeed. The docility to accept well-nigh impossible commands, the physical talents to carry them out, to a warrior born such as I, there are no virtues greater than a steed. I say, be my personal steed, there will be none greater. Furred or feathered, the finest carriage you will have. Your feet I will scrape, and... Lord No Name, I think you made your point. You can stop now, please. I must agree with my lady here. If we agree to discuss the matter at some later and calmer time, my lord, will you refrain from further flying fancies? Well, if you are in agreement, I see no further need for my presence here. I shall take the checkerbo and return north. Krono, we were well met again. You will one day make your way back to our camp, I trust, and we will sit by the fire and talk of glory and adventure. May the new turn be a blessed one. Was that Lord Hawkenfont? I wonder. Okay, so that was a little interesting tussle that they had. Okay, I'm back. Now we can use this. Actually, no. It might be quicker to do this. Yeah, because we gotta go to Ogre Daniel. Might be quicker, who knows? Maybe not. So that's what we're gonna do now. We've already started. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Too late! I couldn't make it! There we go. Okay, so back over to our area. Okay, back to Minketo's. Okay, what you got for us now? In ruin charging, do I face you after such a fit of temper? I tremble to think what reckless words may have tumbled from this mouth without the Ishgardian lord's interruption. Curious it is now how the best of intentions curdle so quickly into an act of spite. The lord has much to teach me in the cleaning breaking ways of the rushing river. If Chief of the Chokerwackers also regrets her harsh words and tranquility and amenity, we have determined to meet again to search for a two-beast solution. The people have seen, the people have spoken, all thanks to Malor. The way is open for the horse, and someday, with the Chokerwackers' assent, we shall canter into Yorzea. Much has been asked of Malor Adventurer, yet more has been given by him. Accept this heaven-stern dish, traditional in the East, as a token of our friendship and promise. May the new turn be a blessed one for you. For you from the far East, we pray. All that for that. One piece of zoni. I don't want... That was a lot of work for a piece of zoni. Okay, horsing about has been unlocked. Blacklist, that was another thing that got added in. A quick way to blacklist people. Lovely, indeed. Okay, so, looks like that's it, guys. So that's all they have available for us, which is actually quite lovely. I'm happy about that. So, guys, on behalf of our reindeer slash horseman, Krono Ocelot, who was able to come up with not only the brown horse helm, but the yellow horse helm, the red horse helm, and of course the black horse helm, all in one. one guy. I'd like to thank him and Ifrit Eggy for being very patient with us and traveling around. So yeah, on behalf of Chrono, Ifrit, and of course myself, I'd like to thank you guys for watching this edition of Game Time with Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn for the PlayStation 3. And until next time, guys, this is all of us saying goodbye, farewell, and we will see you next time.